Hello friends, hello YouTube. In this video, I will explain you how you can use FFmpeg, which is a free video editing software, to merge lots of different images to a time-lapse video. For example, if you have taken your camera, put it onto an interval of 2 seconds, 5 seconds, 10 seconds. This depends on the amount of time you want to cover in your time-lapse. You end up typically with different files. So you have the images, they start counting and counting. So in my case, I had 400 images now that I want to merge to a final video. I don't want to paste all those images into like the video editing software, set there the time, export the video. Then again, I found this quite tedious. And then I did some research and found this technique with FFmpeg, which I think is actually quite helpful. So our task is as follows. We want to reduce the time each image takes up in the video. Then we take up all those reduced images and merge it to our big final video. It is not necessarily big in the time span, but it's definitely larger than one single image. And this can be done easily with FFmpeg. And to start off, I will show you how or which command you have to enter. So first of all, the first thing you should do is to look up your start number, because this is relevant when you enter the FFmpeg command later on. The start number can be different for every folder where you look at your file sequence, because depending on the camera type and the software and so on, it can happen that the software itself creates multiple folders over the whole time steps. So you might have a folder that contains the first 400 images, then a second one with the other 400 images and so on. And so this is actually quite typical, and therefore it's definitely beneficial if you note your start number. So we can just look at our first files by entering ls, and then we can look at our first files. So we pass it to our head command, and there we see we have our starting value is 188.83.jpg. And in the next step, I will explain you the command you use, or the command flags you pass to FFmpeg. So we start off by defining the images, the format we have is we have an image format. Yeah, you have different types. You can enter that. That's what you have to enter it here. Then you set your frame rate. In this case, this is 25. You can also make a slower frame rate. Then the whole video gets longer. A higher frame rate, the video gets shorter. You can play around depending on the final speed you want to obtain. Otherwise, you can also edit the speed of the final video. This is totally up to you. Then we pass our start number. So as I already said, here we have 18883. And the next thing you want to enter is the template of each, the file name template, to be more precise. We see that each image starts with G00 and then comes a digit. And those digits are increasing. And to define this increasing image counter, you can just say the percentage sign, then the D, and then comes your file ending. And then in the end, you can just define your time-lapse. In this case, I've already created a video. We override it in this case. And now you start how FFmpeg merges all those files into this whole time-lapse video. And this video can be later on used by you to imported it to a video editing software to underlie it with music and so on. And if you have liked this video so far, hit the subscribe button and see you next time. Bye bye.